The music for Spirit Stallion of the Cimarron is performed by world-renowned recording artist Brian Adams, with an original score by Hans Zimmer, Academy Award-winning composer. Spirit's unconventional narrative is told through the film's songs and score, which posed an unprecedented challenge to composer Hans Zimmer.
Jeffrey phones up and says, how to make a movie about a horse in the Wild West. Oh, and by the way, the horse won't speak. And oh, by the way, the music has to be its voice. Jeffrey basically said to me that this is going to be an experiment. And I'm always into a bit of an experiment. You know, the impossible is always, you know, the fascinating thing. I always come to a movie with a point of view and a plan. I'm going, this is what we're going to do. And I had a really great plan on this one. After all, it's the American West, so I hired every great guitar slinger in town. I was supposed to tell the story from the horse's point of view, and as soon as you heard somebody go plonk, you know, you knew there was a human being somewhere in the shot. You know, that idea didn't work, so I threw that away, and then I went, okay, let's go totally abstract. Let's go electronic. I did that for about a year, and that was really boring. Finally, I realized, you know, try to write good melodies. Ultimately, you know, it has actually become this metamorphosis of all these different styles. You know, there are guitars now in it. There's still lots of electronics in it, and there's an orchestra. You know, so it's got everything and more.
Well, Hans is such a genius on so many levels musically. His music conveys emotions and attitudes like no other, which is really what the best musical scores do. They help tell the story.
The first time you meet Spirit, you hear a song that Brian and I wrote called Here I Am, and we gave Brian very strict instructions about the lyrics on the song, which was really be very metaphorical, don't be specific, you know. So the first line he gives us is, here I am.
Here I am, this is me. I come to this world so wild and free.
And we went, okay, let's change our minds. You're right, we go with that. So you see the character and you hear the words, here I am. You know, there's no doubt about it.
For the Spirit soundtrack, Brian Adams sings a duet with Sarah McLachlan called Don't Let Go.
These songs are telling his story, and my role really is storyteller, sort of to try to bring the emotion through my voice and bring him alive. There's a playful side to Spirit, and that is the side that he, you know, he's cocky, he's young, he's bullish, he's full of, you know. So I wrote a song called Get Off My Back, which is like, you know, you can try and ride me, but you're not going to get there. And no matter how hard you try, it's not going to happen, because you're going to end up in the dirt.
And that pretty much sums up his feelings towards, you know, anybody who's trying to ride him. And it's really gutsy and driving and, you know, a fun song.
Brian's a rock and roller. And so, you know, with that, you know, comes a little bit of that bad boy spirit, you know, and we needed that.
And that's why I related to the picture, because it wasn't about trying to be something I'm not. It was about trying to be me in this character.
If there was a place in this movie for Brian to express Brian and be Brian, that was it.
You you'd have to get an emotional thing, which might mean changing the melody or finding a lyric that works. And sometimes a mumble becomes a lyric. It was really like getting a big jigsaw puzzle and trying to find the pieces that fit together. You can't take me.
Ryan brought this raw energy to Spirit, the rock and roll, the energy that he has when he sings, the rawness, the emotion that he brings to it. Brian brought that to the table in spades.
Brian's songs, they're incredibly heartfelt and incredibly passionate, and they help the audience kind of keep involved in how, you know, in where Spirit is at any given point in the film. They're like his conscience in a way.
Sound the bugle now. Play it just for me.
The song on the train is called Sound the Bugle. And he's busted at that point. He's at the lowest possible ebb he could possibly be.
I'm a soldier, wounded, so I must give up the fight.
It's not a pop song. It's like a piece of music that's has a little narrative through it that, you know, is full of metaphors and describing his, you know, his inner strength.
Or leave me lying here.
For Brian, I think it was an extraordinary challenge because we needed him to be a singer, a songwriter, and an actor.
The first single from the film soundtrack is a remix of Here I Am.
It's almost like a hip-hop track now, which is great. I mean, I think the groove really works really well for the song. Up until the, you know, the last few weeks of making the soundtrack, it wasn't even considered as a song. It wasn't until we got involved with DreamWorks and Michael Austin actually heard the song, who's the head of the record division there. I was thrilled when I heard what they'd done because it was like, oh, I would never have done that.
Bryan Adams collaborated with Hans Zimmer to compose the film's theme song, I Will Always Return.
I hear the wind call my name, the sound that leads me home again.
All the songs in this movie really are Spirit's inner thoughts, you know, because after all, he doesn't speak. Will always return, you know, it doesn't matter how far away I, you know, any of us will always go. There is a place we want to come back to and we will come back to if we just persevere.
I think it's a pretty beautiful song. It is sort of the crown jewel of this picture.
It's hard to write a good melody, it's hard to write a good song. You know, you write from your gut, you write from instinct. And this was one of the most enjoyable experiences for me because, let me be honest, I'm a complete lunatic. I love my work and I love digging in and just going, no, 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 it could all be better and it could all be different and let's just throw it all out and start again and experiment and go to dangerous places and be reckless about it. You know, why get up in the morning unless you're gonna have an adventure? As the seconds of our life are ticking away, you have to be aware that it needs to be an adventure.
Return.